Hi there, Simon from simonwood.com. Today I have got a lineup of three Douro whites, all from the same estate. I don't know whether they're all from the same estate. They're all from a producer called Quinta de Romanera, but I don't know whether they're all estate fruit, because the first one doesn't say Quinta de Romanera on the front. It just says Sino de Romanera. And the Sino de Romanera white wine vinified from Verdello and Malvasia Fina. The name Sino refers to the Portuguese word for the ancient bell that hangs over the entrance to the main house of the property and which is reproduced on the label of the wine. They're all 2013. I think I'm doing them in the right order. If I'm not, we'll find out as we go along. Anyway, give this one a whirl. Now, I mean, when I think of reds from the Douro, the thing that they remind me perhaps most of is Argentine Malbec, and in that they are full-flavoured, fruity, but with this fragrant edge, and they're often, they often start with about 14% alcohol and then work their way up. With the whites, you'd think it'd be much the same, that they'd be quite potent wines, but all of these have got 12% alcohol. Here, I don't know whether it's the Verdello that's speaking, but you get this really nice, tangy, crunchy, ripe pear character, almost like a Bordeaux Sauvignon style of character. I don't think there's any oak influence here. What I do seem to get is there's a fine, herby, stroke, stony character behind the fruit. So it feels like there's going to be quite nice, crunchy fruit, but with a minerally underbelly. I really feel it going along the sides of my tongue there. There's the crisp element. There's that tangy green. I was talking about it smelling more of pear. It's the apple flavours that I get, and it's those ripe green apples. Maybe getting a little bit into the coxes and things like that. And then this stoniness. But then when I think of Verdello, I usually think of it as this quite a crunchy, waxy walnut sometimes I get in some of the wines. Pear is a character I get a lot. And there's a richness there, and it's richness of flavour rather than richness of texture. So it's crisp but rich in flavour. It feels like a nice, one of those wines that you'd sort of like sit there and suddenly look and you think, oh dear, we finished the bottle, which is always a good sign for me for a wine. So maybe I better have another slug of it. Yeah, I like that, and I like the persistence there. It feels like, for a wine that's not particularly high in flavour, high in alcohol, not high in flavour, blah. Got a lot to say for itself. Next one down. And the next one, both labelled Quinta de Romanera. And again, 2013, 12%. Grapes here, Malvasia Fina and Gouveo. So the Malvasia, it's having the upper hand here. It doesn't say the percentages on the other one. No, I was just checking. And the Malvasia, I didn't notice it as much in the Sino de Romanera, but here I get that what I call the honeyed honeysuckle character that I find in a lot of Malvasia. It feels like it's going to have this extra layer of corpulence, but again, in terms of flavour rather than in terms of weight and power. But maybe not the crunchiness and of the orchard fruit that you're getting in the first one. Really nice, again, sprightly wine. As I suspected, it doesn't seem to be as fruit forward as the Sino de Romanera, but there are other things that are going on there. So there is this heady blossom character, but there's also more of the stoniness, more of the, I don't know whether it's the slightly different accent on the grapes, and it's the Gouveo that's transmitting more of this slaty type of terroir feel. I'm not sure what the vineyard would be like in it, where they've got these, what the type of soil is, but maybe a little bit of granite in there that's giving this coolness and the high cheekbones. I do like that. It's got the sappiness. It has got a little bit of the green apple crunchiness that the previous one had, but a different style of wine. Is it better? I don't know. I like them both. I probably a slight preference for the Romanera, but the Quinta de Romanera. But there's not all that much in it. There is something there. Just tasting it again. Feels like There's an extra weight of flavour and there's a texture. And I don't know whether it's had longer on the lees, but it feels that if I were to keep that for a while, I think more of those Life Beyond Fruit characters would come through. Yes, it's for me a step above, but not a huge step above. They're both nice. Let's see how the last one is. And this is 100% Verdello. I'm presuming it is 100% Verdello. It doesn't say it's got Verdello on the front label, but sometimes they can plonk a little bit of something in there and still label it Verdello. I'll shut up and taste it. Yeah, we're back with that slightly fruitier feel to the wine. Should I have done this before the other one? I don't know. It feels like it's going to be a richer, fuller wine, but it's still got that that crunch about it. And I still get this character of the, again, the Life Beyond Fruit coming through. If it is probably a slightly louder flavour than the previous one, but not as broad a spectrum of flavours. Or is it? Let's have a see. Yeah, so that's probably the most rich and mouth-filling of the trio. The best of the trio, I think I prefer the previous one. Here, it's as I was saying, from the smell of it, it felt like it was going to be one flavour, or a less spectrum of flavours, but that flavour will be that little bit loud, and that's what it is. There is this, juicy... maybe a little bit of guava, a little bit of passion fruit in there alongside those characteristics of the pear and apple. I don't know if that's my least favourite of the three. I think they're all pretty good. And you go to the Douro and it's a baking hot place. You're there in the middle of summer and the hillsides are stark. But for them to be able to do fresh, clean, sprightly, dainty wines like this is testimony to what a fabulous wine region it is. See you soon.